Hello, so today I'm going to show you how to create a new job. Once you have that credential, you will be able to log in into our application and you will be able to play around. So first step, you would do it, create a new job. So on the top, we have a link, new job. You will simply click that. And once you click that, you will have this page open where you have to fill out the form. So as per the new job, we have different kind of category. You would pick any category which you want. This all categories are dynamic. So right now we have garments, but let's say if you have furniture or something else, you can put all the category here. So here I'm going to pick garment. Once I pick the garments, what is the purpose? It's a new development, sourcing or other. I will pick new development. In new development, is it new product or product improvement? So those are the options. These options are also dynamic. You can change the wording as per your requirement, and that's available in our maintenance screen. So I will add here, put any number, and who is requesting this job. So I can pick any name, and is it some special organization, or you can call department. I will pick any department, what kind of style they have. So you, it will pre-pop if you have available that style. If not, then you can add also. You will pick the color and what kind of fabric mill they are having. So those are, these are all fields. You can change it or you can make it as per your requirement. I will pick brand, manufacturer, fabric content. So what kind of fabric we have. You can pick any number of fabric content here, 100% cotton. If you don't find anything which you are expecting, then you can simply add it from here and it will available. So let's try here. Cotton 50%, add and apply. So the new fabric content has been added here. Is it first time job submission or second time? You can pick any number of this job submission. Requested due date. So you want to complete this job testing, you can assign due date. So I simply pick due date, go to next screen. Here they say I missed this, so I have to pick again, and that's it. So this is category and what kind of type, it's fabric or garments or other, you can pick that. Once you finish that screen, you have to finish wash instruction. In this particular tab, you have to give the information about wash. It can be industrial laundry or home laundry. I'm picking. Then what kind of formula do you want to use for this particular garments or particular job? These are all the field you can add. These are the pull points that time you want to test or do your testing. You can simply add also here, 22. And if you see here, it will be available, 22. And minimum requirement, you can compare, you can select what kind of test method do you want to use for that particular garments. And these are predefined test method. It will be automatic be selected for that particular garment. So you can change it also. If you don't want, then you can remove also. Or if you want to add, you can add it here. This is dry formula and this is tunnel, like temperature setting, whatever setting if you want when they are washing this particular garment, you can add. You can give the instruction here, go next. If job conclusion comes later and when you submit, this way you can create a new job. And you can print here. If you print here, it will automatically create a new. And if you want to put label, then you can create a label also. So this is the option we have for new job. Thank you.